In this screencast, we will take a look at using controller synthesis for processes where, at first glance, the controller that is developed is physically unrealizable. So here what we're going to do is we're going to apply the methodology of controller synthesis to a system where G represents a first order plus dead time transfer function. Recall the fact that for a first order plus dead time transfer function, or f of t, the transfer function is k e to the negative theta s divided by tau s plus 1. So the methodology of the controller synthesis is that we pick two things. We pick a process transfer function, and note that this process transfer function also includes the valve and the sensor transmitter, and we pick a desired response. And generally, our default response is 1 over tau c s plus 1. And then from those two values, we can get the transfer function for a controller in the PID family, which includes the value of the tuning parameters. So the formula by which we can develop our controller transfer function is 1 over g multiplied by y over x divided by 1 minus y over x, where y over x is this response of 1 over tau c s plus 1. So when we do the math here, we end up with 1 over k e to the negative theta s over tau s plus 1 multiplied by 1 over tau c s plus 1 divided by 1 minus 1 over tau c s plus 1. We could go through some algebra here to kind of get the final answer, but we're going to stop and take a look at this first term. So if we take a look at this first term and we rearrange it, the first rearrange will be tau s plus 1 divided by k e to the negative theta s. If we move the exponential up, what we'll end up with is tau s plus 1 times e to the theta s over k, multiplied by the second term, which, important part here, does not contain an exponential. So the second term is not a function of e to the negative theta s. So what that means is that the controller would have a negative dead time, because remember that the functional form of dead time is e to the negative theta s. It is physically impossible for this to happen. You cannot have a negative dead time. Therefore, this means that your controller is impossible. We now have a physically unrealizable controller. What can we do about it? So remember that this controller synthesis takes in two things. It takes in the G, the transfer function. We have really not much control over this. This is how the process acts. The second is the response, and this we do have some play with because of the fact that we picked it. So recall that we set this transfer function as 1 over tau c s plus 1. However, if you think about this transfer function for a second, what you'd realize is that picking a transfer function like this makes no sense because our process has dead time. So if our process has dead time, then it makes no sense for our response to occur instantaneously. So what we're going to do is change our response so that it has dead time. And the simplest way to do that is to keep the same transfer function, except we're going to add a dead time to it. So we'll have, instead of 1 over tau c s plus 1, we'll have e to the negative theta s divided by tau c s plus 1. So what we'll now do is reevaluate the controller transfer function using this new transfer function. So therefore, the first term will still be the same. We'll have 1 over k e to the negative theta s divided by tau s plus 1. But our second term will be a little different because we'll now have these e to the negative theta s terms. So what you'll notice here is the fact that the e to the negative theta s that was going to be so problematic before now cancels out. So what we now have is, we'll invert the first term here, so we'll have tau s plus 1 over k, this is what our controller transfer function is. We'll leave the 1 over tau c s plus 1 in the denominator, and what we'll then do is find a least common denominator for the second term, and now we'll have another cancellation with tau c s plus 1. We have a slight problem right now in the fact that we have this e to the negative theta s still in our controller transfer function, and PID controllers do not have tuning parameters with exponentials. So therefore, what this means is that we're going to have to take advantage of some sort of approximation in order to do this. The PID approximation can be available, but here what we'll do is we'll take advantage of an approximation which utilizes the Taylor series, and we can say that e to the negative theta s is approximately 1 minus theta s. So when we substitute this in, we'll end up with that Gc equals tau s plus 1 over k multiplied by 1 over tau cs plus 1 minus 1 minus theta s. So when we look at this, we'll see that the 1's cancel, and that our controller transfer function is tau s plus 1 over k multiplied by 1 over tau cs plus theta s. Or we can state this as tau c plus theta multiplied by s. So we now need to do is get this into PID form, and the best way to do that is to separate the terms. So here the s's will cancel out, and if we recall the form for a PID family controller, it will be kc times 1 plus 1 over tau I times s plus tau d times s. As we look at this, we have a term which is just a constant. That will be the p part of the control. And then we have one with the 1 over s, and that will represent the I control. So this will be a PI controller. So therefore, to get the constant to be 1, we have to factor everything else out. So this will be tau over k times tau c plus theta. And I'll be 1 plus, in order to factor appropriately the term with the s in it, this will be 1 over tau, so therefore the taus would cancel when I would multiply out, because we have the same denominator of k times tau c plus theta. So this is our controller. So we have a PI controller with kc equaling tau over k times tau c plus theta, and tau I just equaling the time constant of the foptity. Tau C can be determined by a number of ways. There are a number of correlations that have been developed, most of which are a function of the G transfer function, so in this case, the first order plus dead time transfer function. And the important take-home point of this is the fact that if you have a physically unrealizable controller using controller synthesis, the way to usually fix it is you have to alter your response, most likely to make it something that is more reasonable and consistent with the transfer function, which describes the process, the sensor, transmitter, and the valve. And that is what we did in this screencast, was to take a look at how controller synthesis can be changed just by altering the process transfer function to handle some problematic situations.